Well, they've been preying on young students' willingness to help. Cell phone thieves have been hanging around high schools and approaching students to borrow their cell phones, then taking off with them.
KXY4's Anusha Roy explains how the thieves are carrying out this crime.
When you're not in class, the phones are out. And whether you're texting or have it in case of an emergency, you're not the only one making sure your phone is handy.
They'll drive up to kids. They'll drive up to them, especially if they see the kid on the cell phone.
For the last 2 weeks, a man and woman in a small compact car have been asking to borrow students' phones, making up some excuse that sounds real.
I have an emergency, my cell phone is dead, or I need to make a quick emergency phone call. So it's come across as a legitimate need to get a hold of somebody quickly.
Out of a willingness to help, students hand their phones over. The thieves then drive away.
It was good on their part. They're wanting to help people, but they are being taken advantage of.
Officer Walt Pegram estimates 10 to 15 phones have been taken in about 2 weeks. Three phones were stolen today. There's also been one case at the Spokane Community College.
There's a great market, they may advertise them on Craigslist or pawn them through pawn shops local.
The thieves have generally been spotted around the high schools. Only once have they actually gone through the parking lot. They're targeting kids before school, during lunch, and after school when students are out and about.
Police don't think the duo are a physical threat to kids because there have been no reports of confrontations or altercations. But people should be alert. If you're approached, try to soak in as many details as possible.
Get a good description, get a license plate of the vehicle if they can.
Then immediately report it to a school resource officer or crime check. In Spokane, Anusha Roy, KXLY4 HD News.